it gives me great pleasure to introduce to all of you who have joined us from especially around East Africa and across our beautiful cold nation at the moment for this wealth conference today, to be able to introduce to you our host for this conference, Miss Anne Gaitha, who is the CEO and founder of Regal Africa Group. She's also an international trade and investment expert with over 20 years of experience in this particular sector. Anne has really walked the talk. So even as she talks to us today, she's speaking from experience. She's speaking from a wealth of experience, not only in family business, where she's pulling quite a lot of that together, but also in the investment field, where she has been doing investments on a global scale, not only in California, where she did both her undergraduate and also her master's degree in finance and an MBA. She has a background in real estate and even real estate law. So, she brings like so much to the table. She's also got experience advising clients who are in Asia, more specifically from China. And so really when she comes to us today and brings all these experts from across the globe, it is truly because of her net worth being part of her network. And she has brought that to us all of today. And so Anne, we look forward to hearing more from you, to hear about Regal Africa and Karibu Sana.
All right. Thank you, Angeshi, for that introduction and painting the picture. I really appreciate you being part of this conference. And as Angeshi mentioned, that yes, I do actually work with clients all over the world. I've been able to actually work in four different continents, but my heart and passion is in Africa. And so today I will actually be talking about global wealth management for Africans, because I've had my experience, like I said, around the world. And I will not repeat probably what Pia said, but maybe giving a few of my insights around what we really need to be looking at when we're thinking about global wealth management. Especially for me, my experience has been, a lot of us as Africans have become what I call global citizens, right? So we've studied places around the world, we've gone to work there, we have assets there. So we don't have only one place that we call home. I was born and raised in the States, born and raised in Nairobi, Kenya, and then lived in the States and traveled around the world. So again, where is home? So I look at us as Africans, as global citizens, part of some of us. But at the same time, because we're global citizens, then we've been able to acquire global assets. So if you have assets in Africa, if you have assets in Europe, if you have assets in the US, how do you manage that? And that is really, really critical when we start talking about wealth management, because every jurisdiction is very different. And at this time, when we say a lot of the opportunities are found in Africa, they're also global opportunities. So I'll spend the next 10 minutes just sort of going through all that and really emphasizing even what Mr. Pius and Shiri mentioned, which is, it's not easy to manage global assets, but you do definitely need professionals who will work with you on that journey. And so that is what we do at Regal Africa. We work with our clients, but for us, we always say it starts with your vision, right? So for you as a family, what is your vision? Because for us, we say when you talk about vision, it takes time, it takes dedication, it takes sacrifice. And so what we then at Regal Africa do is just making sure that whatever you decide, we make sure that we make it happen. I do have a sort of short presentation. Maybe I can have Paul put that on the screen as I go through the talk, like I said, around global wealth. So what we do at Regal Africa, we do offer the wealth advisory service. And again, we are the ones who sponsor this conference. So what we do is really work with our clients and talk about wealth planning, okay? Where do you want to go? We then now talk about wealth structuring. How do you structure your wealth? And in what jurisdiction and what what do you really need? And then we work with those experts in that particular part. And then now we talk about wealth advisory. Now, wealth advisory is what assets are you investing in and who do we work with? So for example, we work with a lot of entrepreneurs, a lot of executives, and a lot of professionals. And for us, we create what we call your lifetime wealth plan. It is not about now, it's about your life plan and the decades that will come after you and the generations that will come after you. And so for us, when we're talking about global wealth management, I just wanted to highlight some of the trends that we've noticed. We've noticed, just like Pius mentioned earlier, a lot of parents are saying their children are not capable or they're not interested. But what we are actually seeing, the reality is that the children have traveled outside their home country. The children have traveled outside Africa and they've started their own life. So how are they going to then manage their assets, which are on the continent? So again, when you're looking at that, and things are very different. Regulation is changing. Returns are diminishing all over the world, but the opportunities are in Africa. So all these things are very critical when now you're looking at managing your global assets. And then also we're saying, okay, this family, what is it that you want? Paul, if you could go to the next screen. What is it that you want? Because again, as the person who's leading your family, you have to make a decision and say, this is what I want, and this is how we're going to transfer our wealth to the next generation, and making sure that your estate is managed well. How do you build a family legacy? That to us is very critical at Regal Africa, because this is what we hear a lot of these family leaders saying. I want to leave a family legacy. I want the work that I started doing to continue. Paul, if you could just go to the next slide and the next slide, so then now people can follow what I'm talking about. Thank you. For the next slide. So I really wanted to touch base, because I think when we look at global wealth management from an African perspective, it's quite different from what I've experienced in the States, what I've experienced in Asia and in Europe. For us as Africans, what is very critical for us and the assets that we typically accumulate are real estate. So we find a lot of families that are asset rich but cash poor. So those are the things that we try and rectify with our clients. We also see that a lot of our clients are in business, but they do not have a succession plan. And I'm very happy in this conference we'll have some time to be discussing about that. You don't have a succession plan, what happened? And then we find a lot of also clients talking about fixed, they're very conservative. So they prefer to actually have fixed deposits in the bank. But then we start having those conversations and saying, why are you putting your money in the bank unless you own it? Why don't you give it to actually a great asset manager like Nabu Capital, who can then look at portfolio and make sure that they understand your risk and help you manage it. So that is the work that we've been doing for our clients. And then we also say that you also do not want to only have your assets here on the continent. You want to start looking at opportunities globally. And especially when you're looking at globally, you're going to notice that we notice that a lot of our clients have financial assets in different jurisdictions or real estate. That happens to be, that typically is what we see a lot of people doing. You have maybe real estate in the UK, typically Kenyans, because I'm in East Africa, tend to do that. Or we start seeing a lot of people doing that, also investing in the US and also in Asia. So a lot of what we do and a lot of what we want a lot of Africans to start doing is to start saying, what is the situation with my family? Because your family dynamics actually is what matters when you're thinking about managing your wealth. What is, how does your family look like? What are your family relationships? Because a typical African family is very different from a European family, very different from an American family. So when you are looking at building your family assets, your family estate, it will be quite different. It's quite complex. Different families, who are your dependents. So those are the things that we think are very important that you look at. And you really want to start thinking about risk versus return. We need to move away from just being very conservative and thinking we're going to buy land. we need to take that risk, because as Mr. Pass mentioned, the people who have taken risks in the past have actually benefited. And that is the opportunity we have right now in Africa. And we think that if you take the right calculated risk, you're able to build empires and you're also able to build legacies. Now, again, because of time, I will just say, when you're really thinking about your global assets, majority, like I said, are in real estate, are in business, you start needing to start thinking, what kind of equities should I buy? What kind of fixed income should I purchase? Should I invest in unit trust? What are the alternative investments? And I think for me, the alternative investments is reaching a point where I think it's very interesting for us. And I will be highlighting just three things that I need all of you to take notice of for the opportunities in Africa. So Paul, if you can go to the next slide and the next slide, just because of time, the next slide. For me, I say, sorry, the one before that, alternative investments. Thank you. So when you look at it from a global perspective as Africans, you can invest in the financial markets, like I mentioned, outside the country, outside the continent. But if you're in Africa, these are the three things that I think we all need to pay attention to, because we need to start building Africa and we need to start investing in productive industries. The first one for us that is very exciting at Regal Africa is really around agribusiness. It's potentially the next best investment option in Africa. And we always say it's about the fields of prosperity. There's a lot of arable land on this continent. And so we need to do things differently from how agribusiness was done before. We really need to start thinking from farm to fork, from production to consumption. What part of the value chain should you be participating? And those are the things that you can actually get a wealth advisor and an investment advisor to really work with you on that journey to make sure that you do not miss out on the opportunities in agribusiness. Again, real estate is a very important asset class. Like I said, majority of us have done it, but the problem is we all bought land and left it there. They can't do nothing. The next best opportunity is really ensuring that there's cash flow in your investment. Are we really looking at the hospitality industry? I know the pandemic has affected it, but hospitality is great. Healthcare is very important. We've actually helped families really look at putting together healthcare facilities in certain, in different parts of this country. And there's a damn need for that, right? There's opportunity in healthcare in Africa. There's opportunity in education in Africa. And all of this will not happen without a real estate structure. So you really need to look at that and start thinking differently when we talk about real estate. And the third thing is really around business funding. Financial services, the industry that I'm very passionate about. I'm a banker by profession, but I see the opportunity really is around funding women and youth-run businesses on this continent. A lot of people have shied away from that, but this is where the great returns will happen. If you find yourself funding these businesses, they are ready to take up long-term capital. They are ready to take up trade finance. So if you find a structure around doing that, that is where you'll make a lot of money, either as an angel investor, either putting your money in a debt fund, you know, whether it's a venture capital fund. We've seen families that have actually set up venture capital funds. We see families that are investing in private equity funds, just like other institutional clients. So these three things, if you are in Africa, these are the three things that you need to be making sure they are part of your portfolio, because that is where you're going to see a lot of returns. And so with that, I also would like to then mention something that will be discussed later on, which is something that I think a lot of families need to start doing, which is really organizing your assets organizing your assets better. And for us, because we've seen that there are a lot of family offices around the world, but for us in Africa, we don't tend to see a lot of those family offices unless you're in South Africa or in Nigeria. So what we're trying to say is that in Africa, we need to start thinking about family offices if you're actually an ultra wealthy family, or if you do not want to have a single unit. Paul, if you could just change to the family office session. If you do not want to actually have a standalone family office, what Regal Africa is offering is actually a multi-family office service, where we are saying multiple families can actually get the service at Regal Africa, where we work with you and ensure that you focus on your core business, we help you manage your global assets. And so the next slide will just share with you four things that we look at when we're managing a family office. Paul, the next slide. When we're looking at the family office service, what we talk about is financial planning. You look at wealth management, which I mentioned earlier. We look at property advisory, because real estate is key if you're in Africa. We look at philanthropic management. Paul, you can just go to the next slide. I'd appreciate that. We look at philanthropic management, lifestyle management of you and your family, cash flow management. Financial planning is critical, especially as you plan to take things to the next level. Again, strategy is very critical. Estate planning, we cannot emphasize more about that. Estate planning, wealth transfer is very important. Getting advice in your business, financial advisory, financial training and education. I do that a lot with families. The next generation needs to learn. The next generation needs to learn, and it takes you as the leader of the family to do that. Governance in any kind of organization is very important, and so it should happen in your family estate. How do you ensure the succession planning, reporting, and record keeping? And of course, whenever we talk about advisory, we talk about tax and legal advisory. So I will just end by saying, when we at Regal Africa are looking at global wealth management, the next slide, Paul, when we're really talking about global wealth management, we're saying you as a family have worked very hard to ensure that you've created this wealth. You continue building the wealth. You want to make sure that it transferred to the next generation effectively. So we say we need to assist you to build generational wealth. So managing your family estate is important. You need to build impact in communities. That's something I think is very important. So what is your family legacy? And you'll continue to see a lot of families focusing on something particular that they will be remembered for. And so we say at Regal Africa, when we say global wealth management, it is key to ensure smooth transfer of wealth from one generation to another. And we need to be building family wealth as opposed to erosion, because we're starting to see that trend, erosion of family wealth. So you need to be very deliberate about that, about leaving a legacy. And it all starts and ends by educating the next generation about the values and responsibilities of managing wealth and respecting and honoring the hard work put in to achieve success. And so with that, I hope I have left you with a few things to think about as you continue on your journey of building your family business, building your family estate, building your family wealth. What is it that you need to do, and what are the opportunities that we see locally and globally?